Hello, Pickled Onion Knight here, and I'm going to talk to you for a little while about Wii U collecting. Now, if you're not into Wii U collecting, then this video isn't for you. What I suggest you do is go and find something else that you do like on my playlist. Because what I don't want, once I've done all this, is an entire comment section filled with comments about how the Wii U is rubbish and Switch is better and blah, 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 blah. So understand that if you're not into Wii U collecting, that's what this video is entirely going to be about. So if you're not into that, it's not for you. So now that's out of the way, let's explain. I'm going to quickly explain why I'm doing this. Now, I know there is a lot of content online at the moment about Wii U collecting because it's a console that's been gone nearly a year now, and there's a lot of videos that are going to be quite similar to this that you could go and watch. But what I've noticed is that they are all very American-centric. Whereas I'm hoping what I'm trying to do with this one is give it a more sort of European feel. Because it's reasonably difficult to find relevant information to European collectors online. It's not as easy as you might think it would be. So I'm going to try and do that, and it's going to be more UK centric than European centric. But even if you do live in the US or maybe in Japan, I don't know, then something might be relevant to you. So I do urge you to stay watching because you might still get something relevant out of it, even though it's not to do with your particular region. Well, some of it is, but that'll come towards the end. So let me just explain. About a year ago, I bought a Wii U, and I think it's an absolutely fantastic console. And the good thing about collecting for the Wii U is there's not a massive library. There's very much a library of dwindling exclusives now that a lot of stuff is being released on other consoles, most notably the Switch, but also the PS4 and things like that. So the reasons, I'm not going to go into the reasons behind collecting for the Wii U. Now, if you're watching this video, I'm assuming you've already decided you want to. So let me just arm you with some of the information that you might need, because understand that I am also collecting for the Wii U. I'm not sure yet whether I'm going for a full set or not. That remains to be seen, because some of the titles I do already have on other consoles. But I'm probably going to get quite a large majority of the set, and certainly anything that's exclusive to the console. So I'll just start by saying that. But the first thing I want to go into is the actual variants of console themselves. Now, there are two main variants, or two main console variants, and one special variant in particular. Now, there's the white one, which is the white console with the white gamepad, hopefully I've put up some pictures here. And that is the 8GB version. Now, this is not the sought-after version. This is the basic version as it was when it came out. Then there's the 32GB version, which is exactly the same, only black, and has 32GB of onboard storage. I mean, it's less of an issue which one you get now because you can actually use an external hard disk as your main storage. So it's actually less of an issue which one you get. But it was a big deal when the consoles first came out. The black one, of course, being much more expensive. The other variant I want to talk about is there is a Legend of Zelda variant available. And this is pretty much exactly the same console as the 32GB black version, only it has some Legend of Zelda decals around the gamepad, and it comes with a copy of Wind Waker, or was it Twilight Princess? It comes with one of the remastered Zelda games anyway. I think it was Wind Waker, but that's the only variant in which you'll see of the actual console. Now, I just want to add some tips. As far as I'm aware, there is no one left in the UK that is selling new consoles. So that's pretty much, if you live in the UK, that's pretty much off the table. I did a quick bit of research this evening to see if I could find anywhere that was selling new. Amazon said they had new and used, but when I click on the page, they only had used. So that might be an issue. So you're not going to get a new console. So what do? You have to buy secondhand. Now, I'm going to offer some general advice for buying a secondhand consoles, and then I'm going to go into something that's specific to buying a secondhand Wii U. Is that number one? When buying any secondhand consoles, give yourself a budget. And my advice would be around about £150, which I guess is about $180. I don't know what it is in yen. And try and get a boxed console with a couple of games and maybe some controllers. At least one of the Wii U Pro controllers. Because they are really good controllers. And as usual, usually you're going to have to go on eBay to get bundle deals. You can go somewhere like CEX, and yes, you will be able to get a console, but usually it will be with no game. Even if it has a box, it probably won't come with a game. You won't get any pads or anything like that, and you'll probably spend about the same amount of money as you would on a bundle deal from eBay. So eBay is generally what I would suggest, unless you can use Craigslist or somewhere like that and get a half-decent deal. But the caveat I would add is after doing a small search on eBay, a lot of the Wii U consoles that I've seen on there are listed as untested. Now be very wary of this. And this applies to any console you're buying. Be very wary if somebody has a picture of all the things you would need in order to test a console, but still list the console as untested, because that is basically eBay code for broken. If somebody has all the things they would need in order to test something, but doesn't test it, especially when, you're talking about £100, maybe £150, consider it broken and don't buy it. The thing that I would say that is this is going to be very console specific to the Wii U. Now, be very wary of buying one of the sets with the game pre-installed. There's a Mario Kart set where the game comes pre-installed. I'm sure there's a couple of other sets where the game is pre-installed, which sounds fine on the surface, but bearing in mind that if that console has been registered to somebody else, it will have to be factory reset. If there's a PIN code been put on that console, then the person selling it to you, make sure they reset that console. Make sure they factory reset it, because there is no way to get around that once you've bought the console. If there's a PIN code been put on, that can't be taken off. You have to factory reset the console, and to do that you need the PIN code, so make sure they do that. But what factory reset does is if there was a game pre-installed, even as part of the bundle, you can't get that back. So you may end up in the situation where you have a nice new black Wii U that's been factory reset. It has a big sticker on the box saying Mario Kart 8 or whatever. But of course, you go to play that game, and the game that was pre-installed on the console when it was new is no longer there because the console has been factory reset. So that is one thing to be wary of, is the bundled games. Make sure they come as an actual game. Make sure it's not one that's pre-installed on the console. And that is very particular to the Wii U. I can't think of another console that really did that. So that is one thing to watch out for. So basically, when you're buying the console, make sure it comes with the console, the gamepad, the power supply. The AV leads aren't essential because you're probably not going to use them anyway. You're probably going to put it HD. So that's not an essential, and they can be picked up pretty cheaply if they are missing. The sensor bar, because the Wii U is compatible with Wii the original Wii remotes, although I would advise getting the Wiimote Plus, hopefully the ones with the Plus built in. Don't go for that extra, you know, that thing that goes in the bottom of the old remotes. I would definitely recommend getting a couple of Wiimotes, Wiimote Pluses, if you can. But yeah, it comes with a sensor bar out of the box and hopefully a game. So that is what to look out for when you're buying your console. And this was something I considered a year ago when I bought mine. I considered all them things. And I think I spent just shy of £150 then. But I did get a couple of games and a pro controller and the box and all the stuff in it. And honestly, the system looked like it had barely been used. So other things to watch out for. Now, as I've said, a lot of the old Wii stuff is compatible with Wii U. But a lot of the stuff was just rebadged. I mean, for instance, you could buy a Wiimote Plus in a Wii U style box, but it was exactly the same Wiimote Plus that came with the second generation of Nintendo Wii. So it was just a rebadging. It's not actually unique to the system. Some things that are unique that you may want to pick up. There's a GameCube controller adapter, which was quite sought after for a little while, but you see them all the time now. And in fact, you can buy these new for about £15-16. And this is something that if you're going to play Smash Brothers or something like that, then that is something you definitely want to pick up. Because as everyone knows, the GameCube controller is the best controller for Smash Brothers. Now, on that point, there was a reissue of GameCube-style controllers for the Wii U. There's one or two different variants of them, but these, again, they're very common, they're easy to pick up. It's not something you probably will have to pick up straight away, because I reckon there's probably more controllers around than people that want them. So I reckon you can probably get away with not picking them up immediately, although it is something you might want to add to your collection at some point in the future. One thing you might want to look at is a high capacity battery for the gamepad. This again is not a must, it's not an essential, but it might be something worth looking at if you want to keep the thing going long term. There is an official one. I dare say there probably will be third-party ones that come along at some point in the future. But the official one is probably the one to go for. And that is about £24, £25, something like that. It's not loads of money on Amazon. And that is something that I suggest probably picking up from the get-go. So other than that, I mean, it's really, once you've got the console, the gamepad, well, I mean, the gamepad comes with a console, a handful of games to get going. There are other things that you might want to consider, and that is what sort of games you're going to be basically collecting. And the way I'd suggest going around it is going through the list of Wii U games, which I'll put at the bottom in the description if there's room. And deciding basically whether you want to collect the standard boxes, whether you want to collect the big box stuff that comes with amiibos and in some cases soundtrack CDs and things like that, or in some cases if you want to import from Japan, you know, entire extra controller sets, or whether you just want the rows of blue boxes on the shelves, and that is a genuine consideration when it comes to the Wii U, because a lot of these games, especially the ones that come with amiibos, will actually have extra functionality because of those amiibos. And for instance, there's three, if I look now. Right, I've just found a mistake on my own list, because I've only got two versions of Super Mario Maker listed on here when I know there are actually three. The standard version is just the game, but there's a version that comes with an art book, and there's a big box version that comes with amiibo, and both of those versions come with codes and things in the art book that you can input in to get different things happen. I mean, it's not exactly a feature, but it's like a bonus, if you like, on the game, which doesn't come with the standard version. So that is a thing that you really... The trouble is, you have to know the games well for this system to know pretty much off the bat what you're going to collect. But as I've had to learn it, so too can anyone else that wants to collect. And it's quite easy to learn once you pick it up. So, what I'm going to do now is I have got a list in front of me. And what it contains is all the games that are available in the UK in one section. So these are all games that are available in the UK to buy today. As of, what do we know, end of January 2018. And that is 162 games, 162 individual games, but 189 variants. So it's actually a list of 189 things. Bearing in mind that that's actually 190 variants, because I've just realised that Super Mario make a mistake. There may be other mistakes, by the way. Feel free to put them in the comments if you notice any. So yeah, I'm going to reel off a list of 189 variant games. These are all ones that are available in the UK. Now, there is a shorter list next to it of non-UK PAL exclusive games. So this is stuff that came out in Europe, or Europe and Australia, but didn't actually come out in the UK. They haven't been released in the UK, and probably never will, because as we all know, the Wii U is effectively a dead system. Then I have another list of the US exclusives, and I'm pretty sure this is a conclusive list. Again, if you are someone from the US and you have a game that I haven't mentioned on any of these lists, then feel free to put them in the comments. Help me out, help everyone out. You know, help your fellow collectors. And then there's a list of Japanese exclusives, which is surprising. Because bearing in mind sales numbers of the Wii U, I think the total is 14 million consoles sold. Now, I believe that's right. Of which nearly 7 million were in the US. So that means basically half of all the Wii U consoles that were sold in the entire world were sold... Well, I say the US, what I mean is North America. So that's USA, Canada, Mexico. Now, I'm pretty sure Nintendo didn't release the system officially in any South American territories. Now, I know they definitely didn't release it officially in Brazil, because they came unstuck after an argument over tariffs with the Brazilian government. But I think that basically put them off South America, and they decided not to release it officially in any South American territory. Correct me if I'm wrong again in the comments. But what I mean by this is, it surprises me that the list of Japanese exclusive games, so this is games that came out in Japan and nowhere else, is actually longer than the list of US exclusive games. And bearing in mind, this isn't even all the Japanese exclusives. These are the ones that I could find and translate. It does surprise me that this list of Japanese exclusives is actually longer than the list of US exclusives that came out on the system. Bearing in mind that half of the worldwide sales were in the US and Canada of the system. It's one of these surprising things, and I think it adds to the fact that the Wii U is just an oddball blip. But anyway, so I'm going to reel off all the games I know about that have been sold in the UK. And if this isn't your thing and you're genuinely not interested in the list of games, or you're confident that you know what the games catalogue is as a whole, then I'm going to put a time code down here, and you can skip to that time code on the video, you know, and skip this entire bit if you want to. So, from the beginning, games released in the UK on the Wii U. And this, again, is physical games. This is physical games that were released and I am not counting the Nintendo Selects as variants. These will, the Nintendo Selects will be missed out because, frankly, they add nothing to the game. Amiibo variants and things like that, you know, I would argue add something to the game. Even if it's not very much, they add something to the game. Nintendo Selects don't, therefore they are not variants. They are just a different cover. Okay, so from the top, 007 Legends. Adventure Time, explore the dungeon because I don't know. Adventure Time, Finn and Jake Investigations. Amazing Spider-Man Ultimate Edition. Amazing Spider-Man 2. Angry Birds Star Wars. Angry Birds Trilogy. Animal Crossing... Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival. Animal Crossing Amiibo Festival, big box with Amiibos included. Art Academy Atelier. Assassin's Creed 3. Assassin's Creed 3 Join or Die Edition. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag. Black Flag. No. Assassin's Creed 4. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag Special Edition. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag Skull Edition. Assassin's Creed 4 Black Flag Buccaneer Edition. Avengers Battle for Earth. Axiom Verge Multiverse Edition. Baylor Latino with the PEGI rating 3. Barbie and Her Sisters Puppy Rescue. Barbie Dream House Party. Batman Arkham City Armored Edition. Batman Arkham Origins. Bayonetta 2. Bayonetta 2 Plus 1. Bayonetta 2 First Print Edition. Ben 10 Omniverse. Ben 10 Omniverse 2. The Book of Unwritten Tales 2. Cabela's Dangerous Hunts 2013. Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Call of Duty Ghosts. Captain Toad Treasure Tracker. Captain Toad Treasure Tracker plus the Toad Amiibo in the big box. Cars 3 Driven to Win. The Croods Prehistoric Party. Darksiders War Mastered Edition. Darksiders 2. Deus Ex Human Revolution Director's Cut. Devil's Third. Disney Infinity Starter Pack. Disney Infinity 2.0 Marvel Superheroes Starter Pack. Disney Infinity 2.0 Toy Box Combo Pack. Disney Infinity 3.0 Star Wars Starter Pack. Donkey Kong Country Tropical Freeze. Epic Mickey 2 The Power of 2. ESPN Sports Connection. Family Party 30 Greatest Games Obstacle of Arcade. That seems like a very long title. Or Obstacle Arcade, sorry. Fast and Furious Showdown. Fast Racing Neo. FIFA 13, Fit Music for Wii U, Funky Barn, It's Farming, Game & Wario, Game Party Champions, Guitar Hero Live, plus the six-button guitar, Hello Kitty Cruisers, How to Train Your Dragon 2, Hyrule Warriors, Hyrule Warriors Limited Edition, Injustice, Gods Among Us. Jet Tailfin. Just Dance 4. Just Dance 2014. Just Dance 2015. Just Dance 2016. Just Dance 2017. Just Dance Disney Party 2. Just Dance Kids 2014. Kirby and the Rainbow Paintbrush. Kung Fu Panda Kung Fu Panda Showdown of Legendary Legends. Legend of K Anniversary. Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD plus the figure and CD big box. Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker HD. Legend of Zelda Wind Waker HD plus figure. Lego Batman 2 DC Super Heroes. Lego Batman 3 Beyond Gotham. Lego City Undercover. Lego City Undercover plus Chase McCain minifigure. Lego Dimensions. Lego Jurassic World. Lego Marvel Super Heroes. Lego Marvel Super Heroes plus Iron Patriot minifigure. Lego Marvel's Avengers. The Lego Movie video game. Lego Star Wars The Force Awakens. Lego The Hobbit. Mario and Sonic at the Rio 2016 Olympic Games. Mario and Sonic at the Sochi 2014 Olympic Winter Games. Mario Kart 8. Mario Kart 8 Limited Edition. Mario Party 10. Mario Party plus Mario Amiibo in Big Box. Mario Tennis Ultra Smash. Marvel Avengers Battle for Earth. Which I've just realised I've got twice. Sorry about that. I've got it as Avengers Battle for Earth and Marvel Avengers Battle for Earth. So we'll take one off for that. What a ridiculous misfire. Mass Effect 3 Special Edition. Mighty Number 9. Minecraft Story Mode, The Complete Adventures. Minecraft Wii U Edition. Monster High 13 Wishes. Monster High New Ghoul in School. Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. NBA 2K13. Need for Speed Most Wanted U. New Super Luigi U. New Super Mario Bros. U. New Super Mario Bros. U plus Super Luigi U plus bonus movie. Ninja Gaiden 3 Razor's Edge. Nintendo Land. One Piece Unlimited World Red. Pac-Man and the Ghostly Adventures. Pac-Man and the Ghostly Adventures 2. Paper Mario Color Splash. The Peanuts Movie Snoopy's Grand Adventure. Penguins of Madagascar. Phineas and Ferb The Quest for Cool Stuff. Pikmin 3. Planes. Planes, Fire and Rescue. Pokken Tournament. Project Zero, Maiden of Blackwater. Rabbids Land. Rayman Legends. Resident Evil Revelations. Rise of the Guardians, the video game. Rodea the Sky Soldier. Rodea the Sky Soldier Special Edition. Runbo. Scribblenauts Unlimited. Shovel Knight. Sing Party, including microphone in big box. Skylanders Giant Starter Pack. Skylanders Imagineers. Skylanders Imaginators Starter Pack. Skylanders Imaginators Dark Edition Starter Pack. Skylanders Superchargers Starter Pack. Skylanders Superchargers Dark Edition Starter Pack. Skylanders Swap Force Starter Pack. Skylanders Trap Team Starter Pack. Skylanders Trap Team Dark Edition Starter Pack. The Smurfs 2. Sniper Elite V2. Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed. Sonic Boom Rise of the Lyric. Sonic Lost World. Splatoon. Splatoon Amiibo Edition Big Box. SpongeBob SquarePants Plankton's Robotic Revenge. Star Fox Zero. Star Fox Zero First Print Edition including Star Fox Guard. SteamWorld Collection. Super Mario 3D World, Super Mario Maker, Super Mario Maker plus Amiibo, big box. I've already explained that I have missed one out here, which is Super Mario Maker plus art book, so like special edition version. So add that in. It's not on the list. Super Smash Brothers for Wii U. Super Smash Brothers for Wii U plus GameCube adapter, big box. Super Smash Brothers for Wii U plus Mario Amiibo, big box. Tank, Tank, Tank. That's not three games, it's one. Tekken Tag Tournament 2 Wii U edition. Terraria. Tesla Grad. Tokyo Mirage Sessions hashtag FE or pound sign FE, depending on how you want to say it. I've just noticed another one that I've missed out. Tokyo Mirage Sessions FE special edition in the big box, and that's not on this list either. So even I'm noticing mistakes as I'm going through it. That's how collectors work. They go, that doesn't look right. So add that one into your personal list. Where did we get to? Yes, Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Blacklist, Transformers Prime the Game, Transformers Rise of the Darkspark, Tumblestone, Turbo Super Stunt Squad, The Walking Dead Survival Instinct, Warriors Orochi 3 Hyper, Watch Dogs, Watch Dogs Special Edition, Wii U plus Fit Meter, big box. Wii Fit U plus Fit Meter, big box. Wii Fit U with Balance Board plus Fit Meter, even bigger box. Wii Party U with Black Wiimote Plus. Wii Party U with White Wiimote Plus. Wii Sports Club. Wonderful 101. Xenoblade Chronicles X. Xenoblade Chronicles X Limited Edition. Yoshi's Woolly World. Yoshi's Woolly World Giant Blue Amiibo Edition. Yoshi's Woolly World Giant Green Amiibo Edition. Yoshi's Woolly World Giant Pink Amiibo Edition. Your Shape Fitness Evolved 2013. Zombie U. And finally, Zumba Fitness World Party with Zumba Belt. So that was give or take 162 games with 189 variants. And that is all that is available at retail in the UK as of this moment. Now, let me get these other lists out of the way, and then I will explain how I'm going to sort my collection out. Okay, so we'll move on to the PAL non-UK. So this is stuff that was released in continental Europe, but for some reason or another, usually language, it looks like, weren't released in the UK. And this is only the ones I know about. This is only the ones that I could find that I know about. This list may expand at some point in the future. So we've got Balia Latino. Now, I know this was on the other list, but for some reason, PEGI, which is the Pan-European Game Enforcers, I can't remember what the I stands for, but basically they do the rating system in Europe. They're similar to the ESRB ratings as you would get in the US. But for some reason, the continental version of this game is PEGI 12. Whereas the UK version is PEGI 3. Now, I can only assume that's because some of the content is different on the continental version. So, because some of the game content is actually different, which again is an assumption I'm making, but I can't think of any other reason why it would be PEGI 12 everywhere else in Europe and PEGI 3 specifically for the UK version. I am going to count that as a variant. So if officially, if you were to ask me, officially, that would count to me as a variant. So if you see the PEGI 12 version, it's the continental European version. Anyway, let's get on. Cocoteau 2, Magic Circus, plus guns. So that is little guns that come with it that hold Wii Remote pluses. It's a shooting game. Hunter's Trophy 2, Europa, with black rifles. Again, it's not a real rifle. It's a plastic thing that holds a Wiimote. And then there's a variant on that, which is Hunter's Trophy 2 Europa, and that comes with white rifles. And both of them, I think, are German exclusives. So again, in the comments, correct me if I'm wrong, but it seems they are German exclusive. All the websites I've seen that have them are German language websites. So I'm guessing that means they're a German exclusive. All right. Levante All-Stars. And Levante All-Stars, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, with two microphones in a big box. Now, what this is a game that we didn't get here, as far as I'm aware. In fact, I'm pretty sure we didn't get here. And that is basically the Spanish language version of The Voice, which is a US game that's coming up later. It's actually a TV show here as well, but there's no Wii U game for it, although one did come out in the US. So that's what that is. That's the Spanish language version of The Voice, which came out presumably in Spain. Now, Love Me Buddies Wonderland. This, again, I think is another Spanish exclusive, and that is by Badland Games. So that's one that, there's a few people I've seen importing that. So that's it. That's all I can find that are PAL games that aren't UK, that didn't come out in the UK. That's them, what are we, seven games. So now on to the US exclusives. If you left the room, American people, then come back in, and Canadians as well, you're welcome, and Mexicans too. Come on, all over the wall, and come and listen to this, because this is the stuff that you're going to find goes up in price in your collections as Europeans want to buy them. So pay attention. So US exclusives or North American exclusives. Let's put it that way. US is just easier. Brunswick Pro Bowling. Cabela's Big Game Hunter. DuckTales Remastered with the pin badge edition. DuckTales Remastered Standard Edition. Gianna Sisters Twisted Dreams. Jeopardy. Madden NFL 13. NES Remix. Rapala Pro Bass Fishing. Scribblenauts Unmasked. Shantae Half Genie Hero. The Voice, I Want You, plus microphone, big box. Wheel of Fortune. Wipeout 3. Wipeout, Create and Crash. Right, so, what is going to go, what people will want in that collection? DuckTales will probably shoot up in value any day now. Gianna Sisters, probably not so much, even though it hasn't come out anywhere else. It is far more common on the PlayStation 4, and you can buy it here. So, Jeopardy, nobody's going to want. Madden, nobody's going to want. NES Remix, now that's going to be one to hold on to, Americans, because that one will shoot up. Didn't come out anywhere else, as far as I'm aware. May have come out in Japan as Famicom Remix. Pro Bass Fishing, nobody's going to want that. Scribblenauts Unmasked, now that is going to be one to hold on to, as with Shantae Half Genie Hero, because that is coming out on PlayStation 4, although because it's coming out on PlayStation 4 it might not hold its value quite so well. The Voice, nobody wants that. Wheel of Fortune, nobody wants that. No, the two Wipeout games. Now this isn't Wipeout like PlayStation Wipeout with the hovering racers. This is like surfing, sort of, not surfing, it's like water-based sort of antics, but they might go up, they might go down. Honestly, I don't know very much about the games. so I can't tell you. Anyway, that's it. That's all the US exclusives that I could find. And again, that is a list I'm pretty confident in. Unless something gets released some point later this year, I'm pretty confident that list is going to stay the way it is. So Japanese exclusives, and again, this is what I could find and translate. So some stuff I found, I wasn't too sure if it was a different version or a variant of something I already had. So this is very much the part of the list that is going to be subject to the most change. So Dragon Quest X, Dragon Quest X version 2, Dragon Quest X all-in-one package, which is both of the first ones combined on the one disc. Probably the one to go for. F1 Race Stars Powered Up Edition. Famicom Remix 1 and 2. So there you are. That's NES Remix. They got a sequel, which were both on the one disc. There you go. Famicom Remix 1 and 2. I assume they're pretty much the same as the ones that came out on the 3DS, to be fair. I don't think it's a different game from that, but you never know. Anyway, Fist of the North Star 2, or I can't remember what they call it, Hakuto no Ken or something like that, I believe it's called. That could be wrong. Again, if it's wrong, put it in the comments. But yeah, Fist of the North Star is what we call it in English. Something Ken, anyway. They call it in Japan. Now, a variant of a game that we did get here, Hyrule Warriors Premium Box. Now, I could only find pictures of the box on this one, and I couldn't read any of the descriptions because it was in Japanese. So I have no real clue what actually comes in this premium box of Hyrule Warriors, but I know it's much bigger than the one we got. So I'm guessing it probably comes with a statue, maybe an amiibo. I'm genuinely not sure on that one. I'm quite curious. Just Dance Wii U. Kamen Rider Bat Ride War 2. Kamen Rider Bat Ride War 2 TV and Movie Edition. Kamen Rider Summon Ride Starter Pack. So I don't know what that is. I think that's presumably something along the lines of, like, say, Skylanders or something like that. But rather than based on Spyro and his friends, it's probably based on some sort of Japanese TV show that we don't get here. I certainly didn't recognise any of the graphics on the box, so I'm guessing that is probably something that is going to very much stay a Japanese exclusive. Anyway, Mario vs. Donkey Kong Mini Land Mayhem. Monster Hunter Frontier G. Monster Hunter Frontier GG. Monster Hunter Frontier GS. I don't know what the difference is in any of them three games, but they all had different box art, so I'm guessing they're different variants. Don't know. Puyo Puyo Tetris. So if you like Puyo Puyo and Tetris, there you are. You can have both on the one disc. I imagine it's similar to the one that came out for the Switch, to be fair, because how difficult is it to make a Puyo Puyo or Tetris game? And if you don't know what Puyo Puyo is, it's Dr. Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine. So there you are. You can play that on the Japanese Switch, and you don't need to have a Mega Drive. Romance of the Three Kingdoms 12. Romance of the Three Kingdoms 12 plus Power Up Kit. Taiko Drum Master Collect Star Friends Battle. Now, that is literally what that translated as. So I have no idea if you retranslated that back into Japanese, it would still say the same thing. But that is literally what that translated as. Taiko no Tatsujin. Taiko no Tatsujin plus drums and sticks. Big box. Wii Karaoke U plus microphone. Big box. Yakuza 1 and 2 HD. So that's both Yakuza games on one disc. Now, I believe this is coming out for PlayStation 4 at some point in the future, so fingers crossed you won't have to import this very, very expensive Wii U game from Japan. Yokai Watch Dance Special plus Bree Captain Song Medal. As in Bree the Cheese and Captain the Army Rank. Again, this could be a mistranslation, but as far as I know, it's correct. So keep your keep a lookout for that one, the Yokai Watch Dance Special. So now that we know pretty much what the entire collection is, almost worldwide, and like I say, what I'm going to do is, if I have failed to put anything, then please do put it in the comments. And what I will do, I will write a list in the description of everything I've got here. And I already have to update it because there's a couple of things that I've just noticed are actually missing off this list. And I will update the list as I go. So hopefully the idea being is that if you click on this video and look at the list, then it will, you know, it will have a completely updated list of everything to look for. But now that we know this, then what do you do? How do you actually go about collecting? And let's just say you are going for a full set, whichever territory you live in. I'm going to offer some general advice and then some quite specific advice that pertains to the Wii U in particular. So general advice would be, go for the collector's editions and things like that first, because that's the stuff that is going to disappear off store shelves the fastest and is going to rise up in price the fastest on eBay and things like that. Your games that sold a lot, I mean, for instance, yeah, you could go out and buy Super Mario Bros. U or Super Mario 3D World, but why? What's the point? You're definitely going to find it cheaper at some point in the future. You probably are going to find it in a charity shop at some point, or what's the American version? A Goodwill, I suppose. You are going to find the stuff like that. So let me just go through some highlights that I think you should probably start with sooner rather than later. Now, ignore the stuff about Hello Kitty and the Croods and things like that, because that stuff will come out onto the market eventually for far cheaper than it goes for now. I know these games have shot up in price, certainly in the US. They've started to here because of that sort of knock-on effect. You know, if everyone looking for a game sees that it's going for more in US dollars, it tends to go up here as well for some reason, even though you can walk into pretty much any branch of game in the country at the moment and still find a new copy of Hello Kitty Cruisers. For some reason, it's going for more money on eBay. I don't understand that. Because I can literally go to my local game tomorrow and pay 12 quid and it's mine. Probably even less if they've got it as a pre-owned. But I don't want it. It's a pile of rubbish. And the only time I would want it is if I do decide at some point in the future to go for an entire set, which I'm not at the moment. But like I say, go for the big box stuff first, especially the Zeldas, the Lego stuff that comes with the minifigures, if you're into that, because that is stuff that once it's gone, you'll never see it again. You're not going to find that turning up complete in charity shops in a year's time, 2 years' time, whenever. It's just not going to happen. The same goes for the Amiibo stuff. You know, you might find the game at some point in the future, the version of the game that says not for resale on the box, that so you know it did originally come in a big box. But you're unlikely to find the box it came in. You're unlikely to find the Amiibos. In the case of the Animal Crossing set, there's not only the two Amiibos with it, but there's also a set of five cards in there. They're definitely going to be unwrapped and missing. Things like that. I mean, special editions, Assassin's Creed Black Flag Edition, Buccaneer Edition, rather. The extra bits and pieces that came with that, you're not going to find. So it's probably at its cheapest now that it ever will be. So that's a warning to you. If you turn around at some point in the future, in 2 years' time, 3 years' time, and say, I want to collect for Wii U, I want to get this special edition, then you know, if you think that might be the case, then I would advise you start now, because that stuff is only going to go up and up. I dare say with this console, the crap is really going to stay, at some point is going to plummet. So if you are one of these people that have spent 40 quid on Hello Kitty cruisers, be prepared that in a year's time, it's going to be worthless. Nobody's going to want it. Nobody is going to pay the money for that game. So that is kind of the general that would apply to every console anyway. I mean, the special editions generally go up unless they're completely useless. I mean, like, you know, if it's something like a Steelbook, that's never going to go up. Even though people think the Steelbooks do go up, they actually don't. They pretty much stay as they are. And they're not any more collectible than the standard variants usually. But things like that, I mean, it's use a bit of common sense and think what is never going to go down in price and what is only going to continuously go up. And it's pretty much the standard rules. But so the one thing that pretty much is unique to the Wii U that isn't unique to the other consoles, I mean, is the Toys to Life sort of aspect of it. Pretty much the three main Toys to Life, and in fact, talking of Toys to Life, I think I've missed out the Lego ones. No, Lego Dimensions, I do have that there. The main four Toys to Life are all represented on the Wii U. So you've got the three that are on everything. That's Lego Dimensions, Disney Infinity, and Skylanders. Now, they're on everything. The things about Toys to Life that are unique to the Wii U is, number one, when it comes to the Skylanders, there are actually unique Nintendo figures in some of these starter packs. And this is why I mentioned all the starter packs as different variants, because there are two variants of three out of the five starter packs that come with Nintendo minifigures specifically. They're not like Amiibos. They are minifigures that work with Skylanders. So that's a different kettle of fish from Amiibos altogether. There's the Lego Dimension stuff, but the Lego Dimension starter pack is going to be the same as every other Lego Dimension starter pack on all the other consoles it came out on. The same with Disney Infinity. The figures that you buy for Disney Infinity on the Wii U will work for every console. But the one exception is the Amiibos. Now, the Amiibos, they have functionality on the 3DS as well, but generally they're a Wii U specific thing. They were designed for the Wii U. That's what Amiibos were designed. That's the console they were designed for, was the Wii U. And it's another consideration if you're going to collect for the Wii U, are you going to collect the Amiibos as well? And I have to say, obviously, some of them have more functionality than others. But do bear in mind just how much space these things take up. I mean, you don't have to have that many Amiibos or even any of these Toys to Life things. You don't have to have that many for them to take up a massive amount of space. So you have to design, you have to decide early on, are you going to start collecting them? And this is almost a unique thing to the Wii U. There are so many Toys to Life variants on this console. In fact, all of them are represented. Maybe you have to have a very serious think about A, how much space you've got, B, how much money you're going to spend, and C, how much time you're actually going to start playing any of these games. Now, me myself, I've started collecting some of the Disney Infinity stuff. I have pretty much, I have quite a large Disney Infinity 1.0 collection, but that's as far as it's gone. I haven't got very much at all from 2.0 or 3.0. I have a couple of the Skylander sets, but I haven't bought any extra figures. Lego Dimensions, I don't have any of that. And all the Amiibos I've got have all come in big boxes with the games. Now, which is fine, because generally if you buy the big box version of the game, the Amiibo you get is specific to that game. I mean, that stands to reason that that's obvious. But if you buy something like Smash Brothers, then the amiibos obviously unlock loads of characters in the game. So if you were a massive Smash Brothers fan, you have to think, like, do I want the game? And am I going to play it on the Wii U? Or am I going to go whole hog with the Smash Brothers thing? Am I going to buy the game? Am I going to buy the GameCube adapter? Am I going to buy 4 GameCube controllers? Possibly 8 GameCube controllers, because I think you can actually use 2 adapters with 4 controllers each. Am I going to buy all the amiibos to unlock the characters? And that is a hell of a lot of work and money and effort and space just to play one game. So this is genuinely a consideration that you might have to make if you want to do Wii U collecting, as to how you're going to do it. Probably more so than you would do most other consoles. That's just my advice would be, is if you are going to collect amiibos, go for the big boxes first. If you're not interested in amiibos, maybe stay away from them altogether. Don't even start collecting them. Don't think about the big boxes. It would be my advice generally. If you just want to play the game as is without any added extras, then go for the standard versions. Get a couple of nice controllers. Maybe treat yourself to a GameCube adapter if you're going to play Smash. If you're not going to play Smash, don't bother, because the GameCube controllers work on pretty much nothing else. I would do a bit of research and find out what games you would actually like to play, because some of these, especially the sort of rubbish kiddie games, tend to be jumping up in price. And Hello Kitty Cruises is one of the big ones, but there are others. I mean, there's stuff like the Phineas and Ferb game. Now that's shooting up in price. I don't know why. Monster High shooting up in price. Barbie. There's 2 Barbie games. They're shooting up in price. And what these games have in common is they're all crap. I'm not saying if you want to go for a complete set, then by all means do go for a complete set. But I think you're going to upset yourself when you finally get round to paying an awful lot of money for these games and find out that they're probably not worth it. And if you're the sort of person that thinks you're going to be able to invest in these games somehow, i.e. buy them at one price and then a couple of years later sell them on at 3, 4, 5, 6 times the price, then clearly investing isn't for you, and you're a moron. But there is stuff that you want to pick up for specific reasons, and I'll tell you for why. There's a couple of games that have stories behind them that maybe you'd want to pick up sooner rather than later, even if you're not particularly into that game, because it might actually properly be rare. One example I can pick out myself is the Splatoon with the amiibo included. Now, I'm sure in other countries in the world, this is quite common to have the big box Splatoon with the green squid amiibo in it. But the story behind this, certainly in the UK, was that the truck that had them all on, now I don't know how true this is, but it was widely reported on the news, the truck that had the entire UK shipment of that variant of the game was stolen and never heard from again. I don't know what truth there is in that, but basically this was an exclusive to Game the Shop, which we have in the UK, and the whole shipment was stolen. So if you come across one of these, apparently they're quite rare. Now, I have one, but I don't have all the inserts, and I'm pretty sure the box has been filled with stuff that shouldn't be in there. I'll save that for a pickups video where I'll go through it properly. But other stuff you might want to pick up because it's interesting or for a different reason. Rodea the Sky Soldier is one. Now, this is not a fantastic game, but what this is this contains, certainly the UK version contains a Wii version of that game as well. So that's one to look out for and make sure it has both discs in it, because it's one of the last official Wii games. So that might end up being worth something at some point in the future. Probably not much more than you paid for it. And yeah, if you have to sit on it for 5 years to make a tenner, it's probably not worth doing. But that's one that you might want to buy now. Some of the Skylanders box sets, if you did want to go into that, the Dark Editions with the Nintendo figures, I suggest you buy them now. What else am I looking through? Stuff that's difficult to find. So stuff that isn't a limited edition but is still quite difficult to find. Something like Fast Racing Neo, that came out and pretty much disappeared straight away. Because it's pretty good, and there weren't many copies of it made. It was basically, it originally started life as an eShop game, which then got a physical release, and there was another one that was like that, and it was, I think SteamWorld Collection was the same. That started as eShop stuff, and then got a physical release, so I would advise buying that straight away. Stuff that you won't have to buy straight away. Angry Birds, don't bother. Get that years down the line. The Assassin's Creed, unless you want the special edition, get it later. The Batman games, the same, unless you want, in fact, both of them you'd be able to get later. Don't even worry about it. The Call of Duty games, you'll be able to get them later. Now, Devil's Third is a funny one, because that was touted as rare when it first came out, but it had at least one reprint, so it's not rare anymore, so don't worry about that, you'll bump into it later. Epic Mickey, probably pick that up sooner rather than later, although don't make it a priority, because it also came out on the Wii. And although obviously there's far more copies of the Wii version than there is the Wii U, I reckon you'll still run into it a couple of years down the line. One thing I will say is there are a couple of specific accessories to go along with Epic Mickey 2, and one of them is a paintbrush controller. Now, these are actually Wii accessories, but obviously they're Wii U compatible, so I'm going to include them in this. One of them is a paintbrush controller that changes colour. It's like a nunchuck, a paintbrush nunchuck. And the other one is a little clicker. And I have no clue what that does. This is apparently one of the rarest official products you can find for the original Wii. So obviously it's rare on the Wii U as well. And it's a clicker. I don't know what it does, but it goes arm in arm with this paintbrush thing. So yeah, that's something to look out for. If you ever find the Epic Mickey 2 clicker, that is, well, it's worth its weight, probably. Again, Fast and Furious, Family Party, 30 Great Games, stuff like that. Probably don't bother with it straight away. Guitar Hero Live, I reckon that's one you'll probably bump into in the future. Now, Kirby and the Rainbow Paintbrush, I would probably advise picking this up sooner rather than later. Purely because Kirby's not that popular in the UK, and you're unlikely to run into it in a charity shop in a couple of years' time. So I would advise picking that up if you see it, but don't pay an awful lot of money for it. Yeah, if you see the Lego City or Lego Marvel games with the minifigure included, I would pick that up now. Mario and Sonic at the Rio Olympic Games and Mario and Sonic at the Sochi Games, I would leave them on the shelf for now, because they for some reason have really held their price, and I have no clue why, but I reckon they are about to drop in price quite rapidly over the next couple of years, so I'd leave that towards the end of your collection. Minecraft, again, I would leave that, because there's so many copies of that on every console, that is going to turn up sooner or later. You know, a charity shop or a boot sale or something, that will turn up. Pikmin 3, I would advise you pick that up when you see it. because I have seen probably, and bearing in mind I go to a lot of game shops, I have probably seen half a dozen copies of that. No, none of them have been at a price that I want to pay. But I would advise picking that up, because that is one that was not very popular, came out at the very beginnings of the system, although it did get a release on a Nintendo Selects, so that might be the easiest version to go for. It just wasn't very popular. It didn't sell very well, so you're unlikely to run into that on the second-hand market, is what I'm saying. You're probably going to only find it at an actual game shop, even now, so there you are. Now, Project Zero Maiden of Blackwater. For those of you who don't know what this is basically the European version of Fatal Frame 5, I believe, which in the US was a download-only game. But in Europe, we did actually get a full physical release of the game, but only as a special edition. There was no standard edition. And I have seen one or two on eBay as game only, which makes it look like there is a standard edition, but there never was. It was only the special edition that was released. And this is one that will climb up in price, because as far as I know, this is completely unique to the Wii U. It won't be out on any other system. So this is one definitely to watch out for, is the European or UK version of Project Zero Maiden of Blackwater, because it's Fatal Frame 5. And if you're into that sort of horror style, this is definitely one you want in your collection wherever you live. Rabbids Land, I wouldn't bother with. Rayman Legends, depends on how you feel about it, because Rayman Legends is pretty much on every other console now. I think it was an exclusive at one point in time, but now it's everywhere. Probably not one that's gonna that you're gonna have a problem finding for a reasonable price in the futures. Scribblenauts, you probably will. Scribblenauts, I don't know, apart from the Wii U and the 3DS, I don't think Scribblenauts came out anywhere else. This is Scribblenauts Unlimited, I'm talking about. Probably get that now. Sonic and All-Stars Racing Transformed. This is kind of like a budget Mario Kart, but it is actually pretty good. So buy that now, no reason not to. Star Fox Zero, I wouldn't bother. Star Fox Guard, I wouldn't bother. You'll be able to find them years down the line for pretty cheap, because they're not very good. In fact, I'm not going to talk like that anymore, because I don't want to prejudice your judgment. Things like that are sort of, they're relative, aren't they? So I tell you what, just ignore all the bits where I said the games aren't good and judge it for yourself. That's probably the best way to do it. I'm going to give you my opinion. I'm going to try not to bash any of the games as I'm doing it. Because it is, you know, there's no accounting for taste. You might think they're really, really great. And I'd hate to put somebody off collecting for something because I thought it was rubbish. We're not going to agree on everything. When I say SteamWorld Collection, yes, I'd buy that now. Tank, Tank, Tank. No, that's probably one to get now because I don't see many of them. I think I've seen, again, maybe half a dozen of them over the last year and a bit. Now, I still haven't picked it up. But, yeah, that would be one to go for at the moment. Tokyo Mirage Sessions, I would definitely go for that sooner rather than later. What's the big one that always comes up as well? Turbo Stunt Squad, Super Stunt Squad. This is the one about the racing snail. I would leave that. That is going to turn up at some point in the future all over the place. Watch Dogs and Watch Dogs Special Edition. Again, that will turn up at some point in the future. Wii Fit and Wii Party, they will turn up at some point in the future. Make no mistake, they will turn up. And stuff like the Fit Meter that comes with it, well, you can buy that as a separate thing anyway. So if you find it at some point in the future with no Fit Meter, you'll still be able to get a Fit Meter from somewhere. The Wonderful 101, I would definitely buy that now. Again, with Xenoblade Chronicles, I would buy that now. Yoshi's Woolly World. If it's the big box Amiibo edition, I would definitely look at getting that now. If you just want game only, then I would leave it for a little while. Zombie U, I mean, you can pick that up for, what, £2 now, so there's no reason not to. Zumba Fitness World Party. I think that's probably one you'll find at some point in the future, but if you wanted the belt to go with it, if you didn't have any of the previous Zumba games on the Wii, then maybe I would think about getting it now. Now, the non-UK variants. I would pretty much all of these think about getting them sooner rather than later. Apart from Love Me Buddies, because I reckon you'll probably still be able to get that in a couple of years, and the Levante All-Stars. I reckon that'll be fine to get in a couple of years if you wanted to. Although, if you wanted the microphone, the one that's boxed with two microphones, maybe get that sooner. Hunter's Trophy 2. Whether you want the black rifle variant or the white rifle variant, I would suggest you get that now because it seems to be a single country exclusive. So it will be a case of once it's gone, it's gone. And I'm not sure who makes it, but I think it might be Big Ben. And we know what happens with air sorts of things. If you've ever been a Super Nintendo or a Wii collector, you'll know with Big Ben stuff, it tends to go pretty quick. And I think that's who makes that. Kokoto 2 Magic Circus. I've seen a few of these available. I don't know how rare they are. I honestly can't judge it, but I would suggest you get it now rather than later. As for the US stuff, Brunswick Pro Bowling, I would leave that, get it later. Capella's Big Game Hunter, again, leave it, get it later. DuckTales Remastered, if you want the pin edition, get it now. If you just want the standard version of the game, then I would leave it till later, because quite frankly, it's on every other console. It's even on the PS3, I believe. Yeah, it is on the PS3, because I imported it myself for my PS3 before I realised it was coming out on PS3 in the UK. So, DuckTales Remastered on the PS3, the PS4, the Wii. It'll probably come out for the Switch as well. You know, it's on everything. Gianna Sisters Twisted Dreams. Well, this is another one that came out on the PlayStation 4, so I reckon you'll probably bump into it some point in the future. Jeopardy, you definitely will, because that's going to be in the bargain bin. Madden NFL 13, same thing. You're going to bump into that everywhere. NES Remix. I suggest you pick that up now, because that is going to be one that will disappear. Pro Bass Fishing. Difficult to tell with fishing games. They seem to be inexplicably popular. So I dare say if you see it, probably pick it up. Scribblenauts Unmasked. I would say definitely pick that up, because that seems to be a US exclusive. And I dare say it won't come out anywhere else. It may well have a port or a version of it on the 3DS that's called Unmasked, but I don't think it's the same game. I think it's a completely different game. Shantae Half Genie Hero. Now, the Shantae games are really, really good, so this might be one to pick up, although do bear in mind that it is coming to PlayStation 4 next month, I believe. So maybe hang back on that just to see how that goes. The Voice, again, if you wanted the game only, maybe just pick it up, maybe just leave it. If you wanted it big box with the microphones, probably pick it up sooner. Wheel of Fortune, again, another bargain bin title that will be available everywhere. Wipeout 3 and Wipeout Create and Crash. Then I'd say probably pick them up now, because they again seem to be US exclusives, so they are going to be sought after to Wii collectors that are trying to get an international set. Now, I have no clue what is probably going to be good and what isn't in the Japanese exclusives. But my tuppence worth on this will be probably the Hyrule Warriors Premium Box. I would get that now if you wanted it. Just because it is a Zelda-based game. So if you wanted the premium box version that only came out in Japan, I dare say you should get it now rather than later. The same with the Dragon Quest games, especially that all-in-one package variant. That looks like something you'd probably want to get now. Although, to be fair, for the amount of copies that will be on the Japanese market or the Japanese second-hand market at some point in the future, maybe if you're going to go to Japan at some point in the future, don't bother importing most of this stuff. Because I dare say most of this you'll be able to find at Japanese game shops if you're planning on going there at any point. The one exception to that is probably the Yakuza 1 and 2. Because I believe... I know that's a Japanese exclusive. But I don't know how many copies of that there will be about. I don't know how many were produced for the Wii U, and I can't imagine it's many. Puyo Puyo Tetris, again, I wouldn't bother importing that, because if you go to... Well, you know, that will just get cheaper and cheaper. Puzzle games always do. Yeah, I mean, if you're a fan of drumming, then Taiko no Tatsujin might be your thing. Or Taiko Drum Master Collect Star Friends Battle! Maybe get that sooner. F1 Race Stars Powered Up Edition, I'm honestly not sure. Fist of the North Star 2, I'm honestly not sure. Just Dance Wii U, well, that's probably just the Japanese variant of stuff that of something that we've got here. Only the songs will always obviously be different, because it'll be a lot of J-pop sort of stuff. And yeah, that's basically it. That's me taking it from the general to the specific. Right, so just quickly before I end this video, and I am aware I've now gone on for over an hour, hopefully that will come down somewhat in the edit, but I've tried to be as comprehensive as I can, and like I say, with this list of stuff, with the games list, I'm going to try and post it. If it won't fit in the comments in the video description, then I will hopefully host it somewhere online and put a link to it, so that you can at least go and look at it, or download a PDF copy maybe if you wanted to print it out to carry around while shopping. Now I know somebody will put it in the comments if I don't mention it, and that is the two rarest games on the Wii U. Now, I haven't mentioned these for two reasons. Like, number one, they didn't come out in Europe anywhere, as far as I'm aware. And number two, they weren't store exclusive. Like, oh, Target's got this one, or you know, Games got this one, or whatever. They were literally single store exclusives, and that is the Mario Kart 8 Super Special Edition. Which basically is Mario Kart 8, and it comes with a blue shell statue. Now, this came out at the Nintendo stores, one in New York and two in Japan. I believe it was Tokyo and Hokkaido, but I might be mistaken on that. Not Hokkaido. What's the city called there? I can't remember the name of the city. Anyway, it came out in two stores in Japan and one in the US. That was New York and two in Japan. And it was limited to 500 copies per store. So basically, New York got 500 copies and each store in Japan got 500 copies. The other game that this was done with was Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. And that was exactly the same. It was the game, an amiibo, and it came with a scarf. And that again was limited to 500 copies in the US and 500 at each of the Japan stores. Now, I don't count that as a variant for those reasons, because I'm not going to buy into that. I like collecting things, but I'm not going to buy into that kind of mentality. That, frankly, is stupid. And you know, these are going for quite a lot of money at the moment if you wanted to import one. And I don't see that as collecting. I see that as like a Ponzi scheme. That's what that is. That is going to be one collector buying one with the express intention of selling it. That is never going to get opened by anyone that bought it. Nobody queued up at the New York store, got one of the 500 copies of any of those games and have opened them to play them. To my mind, that is not collecting. That is a Ponzi scheme. That is exactly what that is. And that is specifically designed to make money off the collecting mentality. So that's why I don't include them as a variant, but I thought it was worthwhile mentioning them just at the end of this video for those of you that have made it this far, because I know if I don't, some dickhead will put it in the comments, and it will probably be somebody that owns a couple of them that puts it in the comments. They're showing off and then they're showing off. Basically when you own something like that, you're not showing off that you've managed to get this rare thing. You're showing off how much money you've spent on eBay that week is what you're doing. Now, we all like a little bit of that, but I think there's a limit, you know. I certainly think if I owned one, I wouldn't be telling people, because you'll definitely get broken into. Because people know where most YouTubers live. People have worked it out based on the photographs they post up and where, you know, they film themselves in game shops and things like that. People have pretty much managed to work out where every major YouTuber lives. So just be warned on that. If you are showing off you've got one of these, people know where you are. You will get robbed. Anyway, That's my rant for the end of this video. And because of all the talking I've done, I'm really, really beginning to... I can feel the strain in my throat. It could be strain, it could be bile. I'm not sure. It's one or the other. Right, anyway. So I've tried to be as comprehensive as possible. And again, I hope this video does go well. I know it's been quite UK-centric, it's been very Euro-centric, but I hope some of the North American people that view my stuff have got something out of it as well. And maybe it's opened your eyes to a few European exclusives, if being a Wii U collector, that you perhaps didn't know about anyway. So that's the idea behind this. I'm not trying to throw anyone off the tracks. I'm trying to put the word out there that I've done quite a lot of this research, so... Even if you think my list is incomplete or wrong, which it definitely is, because I've noticed as doing this, I've missed a few out, then at least it gives you a massive starting point when you come and compile your own list of stuff that you actually want to get. I'm not going to do any end cards for this video because I've sort of gone off them. And also, bearing in mind, because of my subscriber count and view count, by the time this video actually goes up, this probably isn't going to be monetized because YouTube's taken all that away for people at my standing, because I'm still very much on the bottom rung of YouTube. So with that in mind, thumbs up and comments are very, very much welcome. Shares and likes and all the stuff that you're supposed to do. I'll try and get this list fully completed and sorted and published somewhere. Even if it's not at the bottom of this video, I'll try and publish it somewhere online so that people can go and have a look at it and use it to compile their own lists. So that's mostly it. I mean, feedback is very much welcome. If you're going to be an idiot about it, then obviously I had this philosophy for a while where I was deleting comments that were just vicious. I mean, some people were genuinely vicious about some of the content, especially if you go back and look at the... There was a video I did on why there might... I didn't think there would be a Nintendo 64 Classic, and I still don't, but there was this... Honestly, a couple of days after, there was so much fanboy bile turning up on that comment section that I was just going through and deleting all this thing, which apparently is not the right thing to do. I'm supposed to leave them there. So even if it's something horrible, I probably will leave it there. That's really what I'm looking for is feedback to this. And genuinely, if you have notice something that I've completely missed, then please do put it up, because you're not only helping me, you're helping the entire community of collectors. And that's what we are, really. We're a community. We all disagree with each other, but at the end of the day, we're all in the same thing. We're all trying to, you know, I may have done myself short here by explaining to people exactly what there is, because there's still very much a lot of stuff on here that I want to get that I may miss out on, because one of you who's watched this video is going to beat me to the punch and buy it before I get mine. But I don't really care. I'm not fussed about that. And quite frankly, I can find something in the future. It really doesn't bother me. But what does bother me is that, you know, feedback would be really, really nice. It's nice to know that people are actually watching the stuff, taking it in, and all that. Yeah, it's getting a bit soppy towards the end of the video. My voice is going. I realise that I'm going to have massive amounts of editing to do on this to try and get it down into an amount of time that people will actually pay attention to the whole thing, which may not pan out. this may end up being an hour and a half long. I kind of hope not, because I don't fancy uploading that. But anyway, I have been the Pickled Onion Knight. I am losing my voice, and I will see you in another video. And I hope that all of this has been helpful. Please do leave a comment.